Well, joining me now from Athens is Dimitris Keridis, who's a newly elected member of parliament with the now ruling New Democracy Party, and Dimitris Rapidis, who's a representative of the Syriza party, which just lost power. He's also the founder of the think tank Bridging Europe. Good to have you both on the program. Dimitris Rapidis, why did you lose?
Well, we may say a lot of many explanations why Syriza lost these elections. The first that we could say is that the party, the government, despite the fact that they it managed to stabilize the economy, to bring it back to a recovery track, it didn't manage to alleviate as much as possible the negative consequences of a decades-long austerity crisis in the country. We did have an improvement in all major social and economic indicators, from poverty to social justice, from the strengthening of welfare state.
Okay, undoubtedly, but if it was that great, they would have re-elected you, right? I wonder, do you have any regrets that you didn't stay radical or didn't stay as radical as you should have been? Do you have any regrets that you accepted the bailout cycle and the conditions of the Troika and didn't go with the opinions of the masses when they had the referendum vote? Do you feel that maybe you compromised too much and that made you lose the next election?
Well, I believe that we were as radical as we could in a very conservative and restrictive framework within European Union and Eurozone. I think that the third bailout was imposed in the country, but despite that, we did manage to bring some positive results. And as you said before, yes, we did lost, and there are many explanations. We also have the Greek electorate has been exhausted by so many years of austerity, from which Syriza has to be blamed for the last 3 years. Also, we didn't manage to focus on different social groups, mainly on the middle class. Mm-hmm. And this was also one of the major reasons why, finally, they didn't support us as much as okay. we planned in okay. these elections.
Okay, and it's good to have your honesty and self-analysis there. Dimitris Keridis, let me ask you, why did you win, in a nutshell?
Because we expressed the popular will for a change of course. Stabilization is not the stagnation that Syriza kept Greece in for the last 4 years. They missed all their growth targets. The expected growth close to 3%, they underperformed massively. And overall, Greece did very poorly the last 4 years, while Europe grew during those good 4 years, between 14 and 18. Nea Dimokratia, New Democracy, expresses the will of the people who want a change of course, a pro-growth, pro-business, pro-investment strategy. And we managed to express that through our Prime Minister now, Kyriakos Mitsotakis, in a very confident and persuasive way. Syriza spent the first 6 months of its government during those the adventurism of a radical break with Europe. It had to then compromise massively. Mm-hmm. We had to pay the consequences heavily, more than 80 billion euros. Greece sent a message that populism can be defeated with the right policies.
Okay.
We see a return to normalcy.
So let's get a response from Dimitris Rapidis. Was populism your downfall?
About Syriza, about the government?
Yes.
Not at all. I don't believe that populism is the right term. I do believe that we didn't we didn't deliver as much as we have, as much as the public was expecting from our side. I do believe that we did many have many wrongdoings in our policy making, but at the same time, I do believe that we did inherited. A completely bankrupt economy, and New Democracy has a big part for this situation, governing the country along with the socialists for more than 30 years. So if we want to have, you know, a comparative analysis mm-hmm. of who did, which party did better comparing to the other ones, its contenders, we could easily say that Syriza, in only 4 years, delivered a lot of things, a lot of positive things for the Greek economy and its society.
Dimitris Keridis, have you read what Yanis Varoufakis had to say about your victory?
Yes, and okay. It will be very interesting to see those two former allies fighting each other.
Okay, this is going to be interesting. So, this is too delicious not to share with our viewers. He wrote it on his blog, his website. He's going to be sitting across the aisle from you in Parliament, I guess, because his party has 9 seats, as far as I understand. Let's have a little read of this. Kyriakos Mitsotakis, the new prime minister, is a scion of one of the dynasties responsible for Greece's perpetual bankruptcy, corruption and subservience to the Atlanticist oligarchy without borders. Tellingly, he has surrounded himself with, on one side, apparatchiks connected to vulture funds and failed banks, and on the other, ultra-nationalist former fascists. Well, besides that, Mr. Keridis, I'm sure he thinks you guys are very good guys. That is a scathing criticism. Your response?
Well, Mr. Varoufakis was brought to Greece from Australia through another dynasty, the Papandreous. He was very close to the Papandreou family. In those days, he didn't have a problem. Of course, he is responsible for closing the Greek banks. The bank holiday of 2015 has his signature, as he was the Minister of Economy at the time. And we still in Greece have capital controls because of his 6-month term in government. In those days, Mr. Tsipras was saying that Mr. Varoufakis is his big asset and his big weapon against Europeans. Today, they are fighting each other and for the radical populist votes. Of course, the Greek people have very much left this whole behind. They only gave 3% to Mr. Varoufakis, and they are embracing the new era of growth. Let me remind our viewers that Greece had returned to growth in 2014 and had balanced its public finances. It was Syriza who returned Greece to recession in 2015 and 2016. And of course, Syriza, although it didn't govern the previous 40 years until 2010, is very much responsible for the bankruptcy of Greece, because as an opposition, it was always in favor of more spending, whereas the old parties would spend 1, Syriza would have asked to spend 10. And so the idea that Syriza is somehow innocent of Greece's derailing is preposterous. Right. Okay. And it's a narrative that nobody buys in this country, for the Syriza apparatus.
Right. I want to ask Dimitris Rapidis, one of the criticisms that the former finance minister and former Tsipras and Syriza ally, Varoufakis, has, he says that you guys enabled the conservatives. You guys made this possible because the right wing was essentially dead from the center right to the further right, and you guys made it possible for them to come back and win now. Address that for me.
Well, to begin with, I believe that Varoufakis as a finance minister was the worst possible option, and it proved to be such a negative man for the country, for Syriza, for the economy. Tsipras acknowledged that, and he many times did say that, yes, I did a mistake by choosing Varoufakis for this delicate position. So as of what Varoufakis is saying about the conservative upsurge, I do believe that he's absolutely wrong. Varoufakis, generally speaking, he's good in theory. He's good in his criticism on the Eurozone structure and the necessary reforms we need to do. But about Greece, he has proved to be not as good as...
But what you're saying, Dimitris Rapidis, what you're saying about Varoufakis, right? You're essentially also saying about Syriza in opposition, because you guys were great in theory in opposition as well. It was, let's give the Europeans a bloody nose, to hell with the Troika, it's our sovereignty, our independence, we don't want to be in this austerity cycle. And then you had to govern and things were a little bit different when you were in the room at the table and you had the responsibility of governing, right? So isn't Varoufakis just a manifestation of you guys in opposition, and it's very different in leadership, and maybe it's better for you guys to be in opposition, isn't it?
Not at all. This is the story of the first semester. What we are saying between January and July 15 was completely different when this had to be applied in our mandate, which is that from September 2015, that the Greek electorate renew our mandate to govern and implement a harsh austerity program, but at the same time to implement parts of our pro-social program. We did manage on the one side to take Greece outside the bailout, the memoranda, and at the same time to keep the society, to give a society a hope that we can build on better days in the years to come. Well, as I said before, yes, we did manage to do some good things, but we needed to do much, much more to survive in the government. Although, as I've seen written behind in your story, Syriza actually lost, but it only lost 4% mm-hmm. of its vote comparing to September 15. So it's not such a big defeat.
Okay. Interesting times, because I guess a lot of people are feeling relief as well that Golden Dawn is out. They had 7% last time and 2.93% this time. They just missed the 3% threshold. So the neo-fascist, neo-Nazi group Golden Dawn, not in parliament anymore. Dimitris Keridis, there was a lot of suffering when I went to Greece and visited and spoke to people. A lot of young, smart people, multilingual, very well qualified, without jobs. A lot of people engaging in unnecessary suffering. What's your immediate plan? What's your first plan of action in order to revive the economy?
Firstly, let me make a comment about you media, and I mean international media. I don't usually comment on the media, but I have to say that Varoufakis is a media creation up to a certain point, mm-hmm. and an international media creation. He has enormous access compared to his very small size and very small constituency here in Greece, in media like your television or CNN or BBC. And it's interesting to see how much interest he creates outside Greece and not inside. He only got 3%, and he's the smallest party in parliament. Just to give you a proportion, we should be talking about the other 97%. Now, our immediate plan is, and already the markets are voting for the new government, we have a tremendous increase in the Greek stock market and a rapid fall in the interest rate of the Greek 10-year bond. This creates a very favorable environment for the new government to upstart the economy, and we want to invite investments. Syriza has stopped, blocked, through incompetency, through ideological blindness, stereotypes, a number of big investments like the Helleniko real estate development in Athens, the Greek gold up north, the biggest industrial investment in Greek history, the Costco Piraeus port development, and so on and so forth. So we want to create a much more favorable environment for investors, foreign and Greeks. We want to do away with the capital controls in the banks. We want to bring down tax rates. And we want to bring in more tax revenues through growth rather than through killing the middle class and the productive capacity of the economy. And this is a very sensible, economically sensible plan through agreement with our creditors in Europe and partners.
Yeah, and it's a massive task ahead. Dimitris Rapidis, is the cold, harsh reality that the Troika would much prefer the centre-right government to deal with, whereas there was maybe the unpredictable element with Syriza. Here, they're very happy to look at the Harvard credentials and to look at the Western institutions behind the center-right technocratic elements in this new government, and they feel we can do business with these guys rather than the radical lefties of Syriza.
Let's see if this is the case. From our experience between 2012, 2014, during Samaras government, this was not the case. This was not also the case even before 2010, 2015, where New Democracy was part of the coalition government. I cannot see why New Democracy can be the good guys, a good allies, or the good students for our European partners. I do believe that comparing to what they have done during 2010, 2014, and what we have done, we did during those last 4 years, I do believe that we did succeed. Finally, the numbers speak. We did succeed to take the country outside the bailout, to stabilize the economy, to bring in investments. Numbers also show this. To lower unemployment about 10% from 2018 almost, and to try to create, you know, the minimum safety nets for the most vulnerable groups, and at the same time create the conditions for our young people to come back to our country. So we actually, with Mr. Keridis, we are actually seeing two different realities. And I do believe that in the next 4 years or in the years to come, we will see which strategy finally succeeded.
Okay. Dimitris Keridis, are you willing to concede that they did some good things and you're building on some of those foundation blocks?
Not really. Samaras in 2012 got an economy minus 9% growth and turned it to 1% growth, 10 percentage point difference in 2 years. Syriza got this 1% and leaves it with 1.3%, one of the lowest in Europe. And of course, investment in Greece is down in 2018 compared to 2017. It's the usual misrepresentation from Syriza, which the Greek people do not buy. It is true that no matter what I say, what Mr. Rapidis say, the markets count, and the markets have voted since the Euro elections in May. They have renewed the confidence in Greece. And it is true that Mr. Mitsotakis does not need an 80 billion euro lesson and to go through a Varoufakis phase in order to realize how the economy works, what globalization means, what European politics is all about. Mr. Tsipras has cost the country very, very dearly, and he will be judged by history, if not by the Greek people, already he has been judged, in a very negative terms. I think those 80 billion euro episode of 2015 will always follow him and Varoufakis, as much as he's trying now to distance himself from Varoufakis. It is entertaining, but it doesn't work.
Okay, well, people will be keeping a close eye on Mitsotakis, and I don't think the Greek people will be giving you guys too much time before they want to see results being delivered.
No time.
Yeah, and that's going
to
be fascinating.
Run very fast.
Right, okay, yes. And looking forward to having you guys back on the program to take stock of where we are with the economy and the politics of Greece. It's always fascinating. Good to talk to both Dimitris.
Thank you.
Today, Dimitris Keridis and Dimitris Rapidis. Thanks for joining us.